In today's episode, we're gonna share with you one recipe for bolognese sauce that is slightly different than the recipes that you're gonna find online. You will see yourself that in the recipe there is chicken livers, milk, and white wine instead of red wine. Definitely gonna use pancetta, of course, and mixture of pork and beef mince. This type of bolognese sauce has a bit more orange than red color. It's very fatty, aromatic, and it's very nice and creamy. Which is the right way to make bolognese sauce? I don't think there is one, because if you get 10 Italian families in one place and tell them to make bolognese sauce, all of them are gonna make it differently. The most important thing when making bolognese is the technique, the way you do it, and the consistency when adding the products. This you're gonna see now in the video. If you don't want to have too much flavor from the chicken liver, you can place them in milk in the fridge overnight. This recipe is gonna make 8 servings, but of course you can half the recipe or just freeze the rest of the sauce that you have. In the book, for each recipe, there are recommendations for the type of pasta you would typically use to serve this sauce with. In this case, we have campanelle, farfalle, tonde, pici, torcio, and tortellini. And now, let's see how to make this delicious sauce. The book recommends to use coarse mince for improved texture. Peel and dice the carrot, dice the celery, chop the onion, and slice the garlic. Take a large pan and melt the butter in the oil over medium heat. Add the vegetables and pancetta along with a good pinch of salt. Saute for about 10 to 15 minutes until softened. Increase the heat to high and add the meat in 4 or 5 additions, allowing time for any water to evaporate, stirring and breaking up any lumps with the spoon. That should take about 15 to 20 minutes. Deglaze the pan with the wine and let it evaporate until half. Then add the milk, tomatoes, and stock. Cook at very gentle simmer, uncovered, for about 4 hours until sauce is thick. Add a little more stock or water if it dries too much or too quickly. When ready, the liquor will be as thick as a double cream and stirred up, the whole should be somewhat porridgey. Just a seasoning one last time. Additionally, you can add bay leaf or dried chili flakes along with the meat. That was everything for today's recipe, which we took from this book, The Geometry of Pasta. If you're interested from this book, which is very nice actually, with about 100 recipes inside, you can find a link in the description where you can buy it from. Thank you very much for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, we would really appreciate if you press the like button down there, subscribe to our channel and press the bell so you don't miss anything that is coming. We usually post new videos every Monday and Friday. We hope to see you next time. Bye!